California. I was working on the Soul Train Awards as a production manager. Got a free ticket to D'Angelo at the House of Blues. Dre was there. Dre and I met some years prior, maybe 6 years prior. I did their first video, Eazy-E. We want Eazy. So Dre says, well, Kevin, you still doing videos? I'm like, sure, why not? Next day, I go to his house, we talk about it. We want to do this video with Tupac, want to party. Cool, easy enough.
Of course, it was a grind, it was a hustle. We had to, you know, we had small budgets, we had large budgets. And so my responsibility basically was to make sure that his vision and the creative that was on that paper, that he had all the tools, all the people, all the proper personnel, all the crew, that came to life.
The great thing about this video to me was the non-judgmental tone about who's in heaven. And one thing Tupac always says, only God can judge me. So he made a point in the casting of the musicians who are in heaven with him, we don't know. So he made it a big deal that Red Fox was the first person he saw in heaven. Who would have thought? You know what I mean? This video, Pac and I connected on more than any other. He was very, very appreciative of this video being done and being done quickly and put on the air. He didn't have much to say, but this one he was happy about.
When he was out of space, he took it over, and he was constantly working, not many breaks. And one of their requests all the time was to have like a case of Hennessy, champagne. So even with
the passion,
even with all of that in the mix, he managed to, you know, maintain a professional, you know, level. And when it was time to work, he really turned it on and was just nonstop. It's like he was on a mission,
right?
You know, and he never really took it for granted or took breaks like that.
I grew up in South Central, beautiful South Central, not John Singleton South Central. In many ways, most of what's in the video, 95%, is my LA. When I say my LA, the Inglewood sign, the man selling bean pies on Crenshaw, Randy's Donuts, the riot scenes were my pictures from the riots, rolling down Crenshaw. So you have to be responsible for your images, because at a certain point, you want to look back and be proud of what you've done. Not everything is perfect. You'll do some clips, you'll do some projects that really aren't so you won't tell your grandchildren about.
Coming down from.
That's why I fucked your bitch, you fat motherfucker. Take money. West Side, bad boy killers. You know who the realest is, niggas. We bring it to you.
But you want to think about that as you go forward, because that's how you keep getting blessed. You're responsible for it, you take it in, you love it, you pass it on, you give opportunities to other people, and it comes back around. So as you're going through it, trying to get paid and all that, you really gotta look past the present moment and what's your legacy. That's hard to think of in the moment you're trying to get paid, pay your rent, and all that, but you gotta think about that. Thank you, man. Thank you, everybody.
How do you do?